Counterpoint, the General Knowledge Music Quiz, chaired by Paul Gambaccini.
Hello. Today we're meeting another trio of socially distanced Counterpoint contestants. In the next half hour, we hope to find out how much they know about music. And along the way, we'll be hearing plenty of musical extracts, both new and familiar. I'll ask our competitors today to introduce themselves.
Hello, I'm James Dingle. I'm a publishing director. I work in Cambridge.
Hello, I'm Pat Hester. I'm a nurse. I work in Reading, Berkshire.
Hello, my name's Stephen Lodge. I'm a support worker for autistic adults and I live in Bridgwater in Somerset.
Welcome, all of you. In the opening round, we ask you musical general knowledge questions for 2 points apiece. We go round in alphabetical order of surname. And if you can't get the right answer to your own question, it will pass to the others for a possible bonus point. Good luck, everyone. James Dingle, the first question is for you. In terms of song introductions, what connects Dan Hartman's Instant Replay, Invisible Sun by The Police, and Prince's Raspberry Beret?
They open with string instruments.
I'm afraid that's not right, which means that we'll throw it over to Pat Hester.
Pass. No, don't know.
Passing to Steve Lodge.
They start with synthesizers.
No, I'm sorry. They all start with a sequence of numbers, such as a countdown or a count in. 10, 9, 8, etc. Pat Hester, let's hear an example of a count in. For 2 points, which band is this?
1, 2, 3, 4!
ELO, Electric Light Orchestra?
That is correct. We heard All Over the World from the Xanadu soundtrack album. Steve Lodge, no need to travel very far for your first question. 2021 marks the centenary of a British composer who won an Oscar for his score to The Bridge on the River Kwai. Other notable work includes a cycle of 9 symphonies, 5 ballets, and a popular set of dances. Can you name him?
Malcolm Arnold.
That's right, for 2 points. James Dingle, here's some music by Malcolm Arnold from the TV version of which classic Charles Dickens tale?
David Copperfield?
That's right, for 2 points. Pat Hester, in the Dickens novel Great Expectations, Herbert Pocket gives Pip the nickname of a classical composer in reference to his early work as a blacksmith. What is that nickname?
Holst?
No, I'm sorry, Steve Lodge.
Handel?
Yes, that's right, because of his work, The Harmonious Blacksmith. And here is your own question. Here's the Harmonious Voces 8. When you've heard their version of Losing My Mind, I'd like you to tell me which Stephen Sondheim musical the song features in.
The sun comes up, I think about you. The coffee cup, I think about you. I want you so, it's like I'm losing my mind.
Is it A Little Night Music?
Oh, I'm sorry. It is not from A Little Night Music. So we turn it over to James Dingle.
Into the Woods?
No, it's not from Into the Woods. Pat?
I was going to say Into the Woods as well.
It's from Follies. James Dingle, in 2018, which legendary singer-songwriter joined forces with liquor entrepreneur Mark Bushala to transform a deconsecrated church in Tennessee into a distillery so he could launch his own brand of whiskey?
No, I've got no idea, I'm afraid.
Well, does Pat have an idea?
Chris Christopherson?
No, not far off, but off. Steve?
Paul Newman?
No, Paul Newman was deceased in 2018. It was Bob Dylan. Pat Hester, if that has whetted your whistle, here's Luciano Pavarotti with a drinking song. Once we've taken a sip from the joyous chalice, I'd like you to name the opera this aria is from, along with its composer.
Viviamo, viviamo negli eti codici che la bellezza rifiora e là fuggevo, fuggevo ora si levi mia voluta Viviamo nei dolci freniti che suscita l'amore poiché quell'occhio al cuore ogni possente va
Carmen Bizet?
Oh, I'm sorry, it isn't. Steve Lodge, do you know?
Verdi, La Traviata.
That's right, for your bonus point. And here is your own question. Between 1992 and 2003, Pavarotti hosted a series of benefit concerts in his hometown of Modena, Italy, with proceeds donated to humanitarian causes. The tenor performed on stage with artists including Elton John, James Brown, Sting, Stevie Wonder, Grace Jones, and others. What title was given to these events?
I'm sorry, I don't know.
Does James know?
No, I'm afraid not.
And does Pat know?
No, sorry.
I'm afraid then you are not included in Pavarotti and Friends.
Of course.
James Dingle, time for some jazz. Here's saxophonist John Coltrane performing with a friend. In fact, a rare recording, as Coltrane seldom worked with vocalists. Once you've heard Lush Life, I'd like you to tell me who this baritone voice belongs to.
I'll live a lush life in some small dive, and there I'll be while I rot with the rest of those whose lives are lonely.
Nat King Cole?
I'm sorry, it's not Nat King Cole. Pat, do you know?
Tony Bennett?
No? Steve Lodge?
That's who I was going to say, sorry.
It's Johnny Hartman. John Coltrane and Johnny Hartman's self-titled 1963 collaborative album was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame in 2013. Pat Hester. In an article for The Times, the journalist and radio presenter Libby Purvis described Dolly Parton's recent autobiography as lush with warm-hearted kitsch. It describes the songs that defined her journey, inspiring the book's title, Songteller, My Life in... what?
Country music.
No. And we go to Steve Lodge.
Jolene.
Oh. No. Songteller, My Life in... Finish the thought, James.
Music.
Lyrics. Ah. Steve Lodge, finally in this round, here's a rock version of Dolly Parton's song Jolene by an American band formed in Detroit, Michigan in 1997. This outlandish live recording is taken from the soundtrack of Under Great White Northern Lights, a 2009 documentary film about their tour across Canada. When you've heard it, I'd like you to tell me their name.
Jolene, 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 Jolene.
That's the White Stripes.
It is the White Stripes. 2 points for you. And the score after the opening round, tied for second place with 2 points each, James Dingle and Pat Hester. And in the lead with 6 points, it's Steve Lodge. Because you pick subjects for the next round in the order of your scores in the first, we have to break the tie. I'm going to give you the track listing of a well-known pop album. Listen carefully, and the first of you to give me the correct title of the album will win. But remember, if you interrupt and you're wrong, your opponent will have the chance to hear more of the list in case they get the answer. Here goes. The Things That Dreams Are Made Of. Open Your Heart. The Sound of the Crowd.
Human League. Dare.
That's quite right. It is Dare by the Human League, and so you win the tiebreak, Pat. Our second round is the individual round, in which our competitors answer their own questions on a musical category or theme from a list which I'm about to give them. Let me reveal today's topics. Classical music of the night. Prime ministers go pop. The names Bond, James Bond. Have I Got Nudes for You? Fugues and Canons. Steve Lodge, you're in the lead. Which would you like?
Prime Minister's Go Pop.
And so, Pat Hester, what is your choice?
The name's Bond, James Bond.
And that leaves three for James Dingle, and they are Classical Music of the Night, Have I Got Nudes for You, and Fugues and Canons.
I'll try the Classical Music of the Night.
Let's start with, James, your specialist questions on classical music of the night. Whose compositions include Eine kleine Nachtmusik and the Queen of the Night aria?
Mozart.
For 2 points. This work by Schoenberg, originating as a chamber piece, was later arranged by the composer for string orchestra. Can you tell me what it's called?
Verklärte Nacht.
For 2 points. Which Mahler symphony features two Nachtmusik movements separated by a scherzo?
The fourth.
No, it's Symphony number 7. Now, an excerpt from an opera which Mahler often conducted, featuring two lovers who are getting up close and personal on a warm evening in Cornwall. Which opera?
Can't guess, I'm afraid. No idea.
It's Tristan und Isolde by Wagner. The six songs by Berlioz, collectively known as Les Nuits d'été, Summer Nights, are settings of poems by which writer?
Rambo.
I'm afraid not. It's Gautier. The following orchestral work was inspired by Gogol's short story, St. John's Eve. I'd like you to name the original composer and his compatriot who did the arrangement.
Prokofiev, arranged by Shostakovich.
Oh, I'm sorry, wrong on both scores. It's Mussorgsky, and I'm afraid the arrangement's by Rimsky-Korsakov. We heard the opening moments of Night on Bald Mountain. Your final question in this round. Which word referring to a short piece of usually quiet, meditative character, typically for solo piano, is often credited to the Irish pianist and composer John Field?
Nocturne.
That is correct for 2 points. And so, James Dingle, in that round, you have scored 6 points. And now it's time for Pat Hester, or should I say the name's Bond, James Bond. The release of No Time to Die, the 25th installment in the Bond film franchise starring Daniel Craig, has been delayed several times. But the theme song wasn't. It was a number one in February 2020. For which artist?
Is it Billie Eilish?
That's right. Music now from the era of Sean Connery, who died in October 2020. Please name the composer along with the film this is from.
Is it John Barry, You Only Live Twice?
That's right. You get both points. Nancy Sinatra had sung the title song on the soundtrack. Dr. No was Connery's first outing as Bond. In one of the film's most memorable scenes, Honey Rider, played by Ursula Andress, emerges from the waves, singing about being underneath what kind of fruit tree?
Coconut tree.
Oh, I'm sorry. The song was Underneath the Mango Tree. Turning now to a Roger Moore Bond movie. This theme was written by a composer whose other film credits include The Way We Were and Sophie's Choice. I'd like you to name him and the singer performing here.
Nobody does it better. Makes me feel sad for
It's Carly Simon. Is it Don Black?
No, it was Marvin Hamlisch who composed that theme. Carol Bayer-Sager wrote the lyrics, but you do get 1 point for Carly Simon. It's from The Spy Who Loved Me. Since Live and Let Die by Wings in 1973, only three other bands, as opposed to solo singers or duos, have recorded official Bond themes. Can you name any two?
Duran Duran.
For 1 point.
No, I can't think of any others.
The other two were Aha and Garbage. Here's Louis Armstrong providing a love song to a scene from another Bond adventure in which Bond and Tracy Dacre fall in love. Which film is this?
We have all the time in the world just for love, nothing more. Nothing less on love.
Was it on Her Majesty's Secret Service?
That's right. George Lazenby's only outing as Bond. Tracy was played by the late Diana Rigg, whom we also lost in 2020. And finally, Shirley Bassey never appeared in any of the three films for which she recorded Bond themes. But the singer who performed the theme song for Pierce Brosnan's Die Another Day did. What's her name?
Madonna.
That's right. She played Verity. And let us see if your score has given us license to thrill. I think so. Pat Hester, in that round, you scored 10 points. And now, Steve Lodge, Prime Ministers Go Pop. In October 2018, Theresa May memorably boogied onto the stage for her conference speech to which ABBA song?
Dancing Queen.
That's right. When Boris Johnson appeared on Radio 4's Desert Island Discs in 2005, he chose a B-list of artists Bach, Brahms, Beethoven, The Beatles, plus this band inspired by his love of cricket. Can you name them?
Uh, That is Soul Limbo by Booker T and the MGs.
That's right, for 2 points. It's the theme tune for BBC Television's cricket coverage, including Test Match Special. In December 2019, when Boris Johnson won the general election, the song that was number one was Dance Monkey by Tones and I. But who came to power when Michael Jackson's Blood on the Dance Floor was at the top of the charts?
I have a guess at John Major.
I'm sorry, it was Tony Blair in May 1997. Blair has always been interested in music. At college in the 70s, he sang and played guitar in the band Ugly Rumors, citing this group as an influence. Can you name them?
You've always been a good friend of mine, but you're always saying farewell. And the only time that you're satisfied is with your feet in the wishing well.
That's free.
That is free. In an interview, Tony Blair said if he could have sung like their lead vocalist, Paul Rogers, he would have stayed a rock musician. In 1964, Harold Wilson presented the Beatles with Silver Heart Awards. 2 years later, the band referenced him in which protest song? The opening track of their album Revolver.
Taxman.
That's right. It's fair to say that no other British political leader attracted such musical opprobrium as Margaret Thatcher. People were still writing protest songs about her 15 years after she'd left office. Which musical is this?
There comes a rain to stop it.
I'm sorry, I don't know that one.
That was Merry Christmas, Maggie Thatcher from Billy Elliot, the musical set amid the mid-80s miners' strike, with music by Elton John, book and lyrics by Lee Hall. Finally, in this round, which British Prime Minister, who had a passion for classical music as a pianist, organist, and orchestral conductor, installed a Steinway Grand in No. 10 Downing Street?
Edward Heath.
And that is correct. And Steve Lodge, in that round, you scored 10 points. After the individual round, here's how things stand. Lying third with 8 points is James Dingle. In second place with 12 points, it's Pat Hester. And our leader with just one round to go with 16 points is Steve Lodge. It all stands or falls on the final round. I'm going to ask our three contestants in turn as many questions as they can answer in the space of a minute. A correct answer wins them 1 point with nothing deducted for a wrong answer. We start with the contestant lying third. That's you, James Dingle, and your time starts now. Slash is best known as the lead guitarist of which American rock band?
Guns N' Roses.
Yes. Whose albums include Astral Weeks and Tupelo Honey?
Van Morrison.
Yes. Which choral work by Benjamin Britten received a full staging by English National Opera in November 2018?
Peter Grimes.
No, War Requiem. In the mid-60s, Neil Young was a member of the Minor Birds with which R&B funk artist?
Can't remember, sorry.
Rick James. Which David Bowie song begins with the line, "There's a brand new dance, but I don't know its name"?
Fashion.
Yes. How many strings does a mandolin usually have?
4.
No, 8. Which South American conductor was honored in January 2019 with a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame?
Gustavo Dudamel.
Correct. An American Dream is the subtitle of the 1992 TV miniseries based on the history of which successful musical family?
The Jacksons.
You're right. Who was the lead vocalist of The Damned? And it was Dave Vanian. Sorry, we had to cut that one off. And so you have scored 5 points, James. And so we now move on to Pat Hester. Pat, your 60 seconds starts now. Keith Richards is best known as a guitarist of which British rock band?
Rolling Stones.
Yes. Whose album releases include Glass Houses and An Innocent Man?
Billy Joel.
Yes. Which of the four seasons links An Evening by Kodály, A Tale by Yosef Suk, and A Night on the River by Delius?
Winter.
Summer. Which Bee Gee teamed with Barbara Streisand for her 1980 hit Guilty?
Barry Gibb.
You're right. Which Bob Marley song begins with the lines Don't Worry About a Thing?
Three Little Birds.
You're right. How many performers are in an octet?
Eight.
Yes. Belshazzar's Feast and The Tempest are plays with incidental music by which composer?
Stravinsky.
No, it was Sibelius. In 2013, Dame Kiri Takanawa played Dame Nellie Melba in which television drama series?
Downton Abbey.
Yes. Pick Up the Pieces was the first UK hit in 1975 for which group?
Average White Band.
Yes. Which word can follow post, flugel, and crumb in the names of musical instruments?
Last.
No, horn. Which great ballerina was married to Tito Arias? It was Margot Fontaine. And so in that round, Pat, you scored 7 points. We now move on to Steve Lodge. Your 60 seconds begin now. The Edge is best known as the lead guitarist of which rock band?
You too.
Yes. Whose album releases include Felt Mountain and Black Cherry?
Goldfrapp.
Yes. Who in 1912 composed the Altenburg Lieder?
Alban Berg.
Yes. Coldplay's song Hymn for the Weekend features guest vocals from which American singer?
Pass.
Beyoncé. Which Ian Dury song begins with the line, I could be the driver, an articulated lorry?
What a waste.
Yes. How many symphonies were written by Sir William Walton?
Two.
That's right. In October 2018, the violinist Tony Burridge retired after a staggering 47 years with which British orchestra?
Pass.
It's the Royal Liverpool Philharmonic. Get On Up is a 2014 American biographical drama about the life of which singer?
James Brown.
Yes. Song of the Wood Dove is an episode in which vast choral work by Schoenberg? It's Girl Eater. And so, Steve, in that round, you scored 6 points. And so, at the end of today's Heat of Counterpoint, the final scores are third with 13 points, James Dingle. Runner-up with 19 points, it's Pat Hester. And our winner with a mighty 22 points, Steve Lodge. Well done, Steve Lodge. We'll be meeting you again in the semifinals. And of course, we say thank you and commiserations to the other two after an entertaining and high-scoring contest. Please join us next time when another trio of music lovers will be playing Counterpoint. Goodbye.